Hello. Is the mic on? Yes. Okay. Good. Hello, everyone. Is this the second time I've worn an ironic shirt? This is the second ironic shirt in potluck history. It's funny story. Well, before I get into stories, funny stories or not, let me say welcome. Welcome to the Pro Wrestling Potluck. I am your host, Scotland Green. This is the live weekly wrestling mixtape that I host each and every Thursday night. I get viewer submissions. I dig around in the buzz bin. I dig around in the rubbish bin, mate, bruv. And I put together a show every week. And sometimes there's a gimmick, and sometimes a gimmick finds itself. And we got a good one tonight. Lots of different things. But first, get in the chat. That's what I used to say. But first, get in the chat. The chat is the best way to watch the show. There's information, there's laughs, there's community. It's sports edutainment. I trademarked that. If you use it, I'll sue you. And, yeah. So, saying that, get in the chat, because now it's time to vote. It's time to pick my poison! And tonight we got a couple Dr. Peppers. I forgot that I was going to give this such a cute intro. I was going to say my doctors told me not to drink Mountain Dew anymore. Who are my doctors? It's these two. There is no CM Punk theme tonight, trust me. So please vote. Please vote in the chat. There's cream soda, and there's strawberries and cream. All right, I got to vote for cherry cream. That's not a thing. A couple strawberries, one cream soda. Strawberry cream is the best thing in the world. Wow, because I was looking, I put this up on Instagram first, you know, let the Instagram people think their vote matters, you know. But if you watch the show, you know that the only vote that matters is the vote of the viewer. The Instagram people, they don't watch the show. If they do, then you're watching the show now and you know that your vote matters. But these other people, let them think that they don't know what goes on here. I put a poll up once where I was like, should I do more guests, more lists, more bits? Or should I just not do that and have more matches? And someone voted more matches, and it was someone who never watched the show, and I wanted to message them and be like, do you have a problem with me, bruv? Anyway, I think strawberries works. I think strawberries wins, and this is the one I was worried about. This was getting a lot of votes on Instagram, and I was like, do people like me? This seems like poison, but I'll drink it. So thank you for voting, everybody. Dr. Pepper, strawberries and cream wins right as the song ends. And the song ends because the show begins. And the show begins with a buzz bin!
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further.
Oh, yeah, we have always been down.
Deeper.
Mr. Jolami.
Longer. Into the buzz.
Oh, wait. Won't you play?
The following contest is a four-way survival match!
All right. Pardon me. Four-way match. Pro Wrestling Noah. Uh-oh. Oh, great. Oh, my TV, my second screen has crashed. Give me a second. Okay, wait, I think we're back. Oh my god. These things. Okay. Okay, we'll go back and... No, it didn't work. Okay. I know what to do. I know what to do. I know how to fix it. I know how to fix it. All right. And I fixed it. All right. All right. Dave in Syracuse, you're killing it with the damn
the second man out.
It really did crash my TV.
The is the powerhouse.
Which is a weird thing.
Confiadores. 107 kilograms of physicality, brutality. Come on! Back in Japan, back in the arc.
It smells strange. Alpha Wolf, or as I call
Alpha
him,
A-Wolf. The second entrant in this four-way survival match.
He's a ferocious man.
All right, so we missed the first entrant while my TV was re-up. I don't know. I changed my whole thing around. I got a different TV, and don't know if that's good. Hey, Wolf. I'm trying to go harder than I ever win. Dumber than the press. Faster than the
Robbie. I'm bop, ever spent money. The second half of Los Copiadores is Alpha Wolf's younger brother. Dragon Bane.
Oh, Dragon Bane and Alpha Wolf.
High flyers around.
Dragon Bane was almost Beta Wolf.
Holders of multiple titles in their native Mexico. Desperate to make a splash.
Hey, this is pretty good. Thanks for voting, guys.
But how will this brother dynamic play into
Dragon Bane, or as I call him, B Bane.
Kansai Air Traffic Control have been notified, Mark.
Yeah.
Well, that doesn't mean anybody's
safe. He's the death-defying, hay-raising Dragon Bane. Our third or fourth entrance.
Welcome, Tom. Banned energy drinks is going in the title list immediately.
There's a ninja in the building, also making his return to Pro Wrestling Noah. It's the former GAG Junior Heavyweight Champion, Ninja Man.
Ninja
All Man. All bets alive. All bets are on the table. Who have you got?
Now this is a match I saw some clips and some gifs, so I know it's perfect wrestler or energy drink. And now, hey now, that sounds pretty great.
This man doesn't move in the shadows, Mark. He is the shadow.
He absolutely is.
He is the shadow.
The human highlight reel himself, all the way from America. Ninja Matt is our fourth and final entrant here. Now then, G-Man, strap yourself in for this one. This is going to be a pulse-pounding, spectacular affair. It's a four-way survival, meaning that it is an elimination match.
You are about to witness a car crash.
There has to have been a ninja mark. If not, I'm a ninja mark.
I was just saying that Kansai Air Traffic Control have been notified, but I don't think anybody's safe right now here today.
Yeah, least of all us at ringside here.
Batten down the hatches. Yeah. I mean, Dragon Bane and Alpha Wolf. Right, these guys,
Dragon Bane,
back
Alpha
in Mexico,
Wolf.
Yep.
But Osaka! Danger follows them wherever they go.
Yeah, they are the danger.
I call them the dangerous brothers.
Ninja Chance, how about that then? Taking a page from the playbook of Tedeschi, I think, with that rhythm. We were saying, G-Man, how does
your two brothers who shouldn't be in this?
Surely they're going to team up on against Ninja Mac and Alejandro. And this is an elimination match.
And that guy's name is Alejandro.
Right.
We missed
Did
his entrance with
then?
My technical problems.
Alejandro
taking on both brothers.
His former nickname when he was in the Congo group. That was his nickname.
Brought him in.
Yep. Your eyes are not deceiving you yet. These junior heavyweights are really moving this fast. All four men in the ring at once here. Alejandro, flying head scissors on Alpha Wolf then. There's the high knee from Dragon Bane. Influenced heavily by Jeff Hardy, G-Man.
Yeah,
Dragon Bane.
I mean, Dragon Bane.
Yeah.
You got to see him to believe him.
Jeff!
I mean, last time, I believe it was Extreme Tiger that got wiped out.
Yep.
Dragon Bane.
I mean, wiped out. They took him to the back. They took him home in a pillowcase.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at this agility from Ninja Man. A true real-life ninja in front of us taking on a dragon. This could only happen.
Ninja Max 33.
Yeah! Right up a body spin from the ninja. Bane back up to his feet instantly.
I mean, we all witnessing before our very eyes the future of the year in C junior heavyweight division.
Absolutely, G-Man. This is what we were talking about. This tag team, Los Galpianos.
Wow.
Beautiful assisted.
I love how there's that brief period of Ninja Mac wrestling without a mask, and it was like, nah, bruh. Get your mask back.
This powerhouse.
Wow.
Alejandro.
Different styles with his younger brother, Dragon Bane, but Alejandro is back and taking on.
When I was a teenager, we had a drug dealer named Alejandro, and we used to call him Alejandro.
Yeah, very fitting for pro wrestling, Noah. The Emerald Arc.
Alejandro.
Take down
I said.
Ninja Mac. Alejandro rolls through over the top of Ninja, off the ropes. Mexican style arm drag, but look at the flexibility from the Ninja. And then replied to by Alejandro.
Yeah, I think you nailed it.
On their feet,
it's like a human highlight reel before our very eyes.
It's like maybe employee of the month at Piggly Wiggly. Who is the first high flyer to do like the superhero pose? Who is it? Who is that man? I'd like to break his hand.
You can only see here in the arm. Get him out of the gym and suplex then.
Folded him up in half.
Yeah, high impact as always from the Ninja.
Running those bananas!
Look at the size for a junior heavyweight, Alpha Wolf.
Alpha Wolf.
Presence.
Little big. Little big for a junior.
Communicating here. It looks like they're going to team up. This is just a smart
one of those handshakes that only brothers know.
I've seen that before.
Look at this, they put the stop onto Ninja Mac now.
Come on, Alejandro, get in there, even up these odds.
The
it's supposed to be a four-way.
Completely overrun here with the numbers game. 2-on-1 from Los Gale.
Alpha Wolf. A Wolf. D Bane.
This then, G-Man.
Well, you've got to keep your eye on Alejandro.
Yeah.
Alejandro, not
Big Junior's got light bones.
And Ninja, here
comes Bane as well.
A Wolf looks
off the shoulders of his brother.
Oh my God! Now that's brother stuff.
Alejandro's on the top rope. The brothers don't see it.
Alejandro,
down goes the dragon. Down goes Wolf. Alejandro, he's got the crowd behind him now.
This is how you start a potluck.
Topic and Hero onto Alpha Wolf. That's how you send down the 107 kilo powerhouse.
And there's Mac. There comes the Mac.
And he's almost invited from Ninja Mac there.
And now the brothers have been separated.
Get his ass, Ninja Mac.
He needs to go about a game plan here. He separated the brothers. Go on the offensive now against Dragon Bane, the younger of the two brothers. One salt lands on his feet as Ninja Mac. Drop kick from Dragon Bane.
Ninja Mac's like a cat.
A cat. I thought he said like a cop. I was like, well, you fuck Ninja Mac forever.
Wolf catches him, lifts him up, lands him for release powerbomb.
Oh, splattered him on the canvas there.
Alejandro rolls out for his own safety.
Crucial to the outcome of
Alpha Wolf has earrings on his mask.
Against each other. High knee from Dragon Bane. Momentarily stunts his older brother.
Dragon Bane's got a rad there.
I'll tell you what, Mark. You got to think Hayata's got to be watching this.
Everyone's got to be watching
this. That's one of the gifs I saw, baby. That's when I said, what match is this? Excuse me, what match is this?
Right up into the crowd, wipes up everyone.
Someone get Elon Musk on the phone. We found
That's so awesome.
And we're not done there.
Excuse me, sir, what match is this? Where can I find this match?
Here comes the ball.
Oh my God.
Here onto his floor.
They didn't catch him. They were there.
The outside.
It's It's like being tied to a train track.
That was flesh on the concrete.
Oh my goodness.
And it won't surprise you, G-Man.
Now would be the time to do instant replays.
Yep.
I'm too scared to do it. I want to do it, but I always screw up the timing on things.
It could be lost on the outside.
It's like a morgue out there.
Later on tonight, we will be spinning the Wheel of Funk.
It just brings that wild card factor, doesn't it, when we have these Mexican brothers here, Dragon Bane, Alpha Wolf,
Baron Von Raschi in the house. How do you do?
Like a close shadow.
Ninja Mac back in there with a Wolf, Alpha Wolf.
Right on the money from the Mac.
They could have shown 30 replays. Oh, Ninja Mac, you gotta look where you're flipping, dog.
Head to the chest of Ninja Mac.
What am I gonna do?
Oh, oh, Jesus Christ!
No, no, Mac dropped right in his head. Mike
Driver.
The empty arena match is on the wheel. So you may watch it again, but probably not. Because there's a lot on the wheel.
To let Ninja Mac be eliminated there, potentially.
And I have a few things that I'm going to add to the wheel, but I didn't get around to it. But oh, yeah, it's great.
Huge pop of Frankensteiner!
Dose.
The green masked man, Alejandro.
Wolf, that was close.
Yeah, he's up against the odds here. Drop hot toe hold into the corner against Wolf. Inside cradle.
Oh, wow.
This could be it.
He's done it. And goes out the Wolf.
Oh.
We have our first elimination.
Oh, it's elimination. I missed that when I was panicking about my technical problem. Elimination. Hell yeah. Goodbye, A Wolf.
On his own.
Switches everything up. The dynamic has completely changed now.
He's got to regroup. He's got to refocus instantly.
Right.
Dragon Bane.
Alpha Wolf gone. His younger brother, Dragon Bane, still remains.
Dragon Bane playing.
He's got spikes on his mask.
I won't really call it standing. I mean, Ninja Mark. Ninja Mac on the in the corner of the screen.
Yeah, he's left reeling at the moment.
Anyone got a spatula?
Change of chops then from Alejandro and Dragon Bane. Ninja Mac, he's back up to his feet. He wants to get involved in proceedings yet. Dishing out some ninja chops.
Ninja chops.
2-on-1 potential from Alejandro and Dragon Bane. Coming back to bite them though. Ninja Mac is equal to the challenge.
Yeah. Keep your eye on Mac.
Hold on to your monitors, folks. Ninja Mac is incoming.
Hold on to your monitors.
People keep catching him. They know you're going to flip eight times.
What's this?
Alejandro.
Crossbody. Wow.
Hits the head of Ninja Mac. And they go straight after Dragon Bane now.
Ninja Mac. Alejandro!
I think most of this match has taken place in the air.
Now, I have a potentially insensitive question to ask. Oh, right in the asshole!
This is Bane Stowman, right on the top row.
Is Alejandro... I assumed Alejandro was a Japanese person pretending to be a luchador. Am I wrong? I think I'm wrong.
Look out!
He is Japanese. I was right.
Ninja Mac with a super kick stuns Dragon Bane.
Keep your eye on Mac. Keep your eye on Mac. Here he comes.
Ninja smash. Wipes out Dragon Bane. Now he turns his attention to Alejandro.
What's an episode title? What did I miss? Ninja Mac has ninja shoes. Oh. Ninja bomb.
Two. Alejandro.
Bye, Alejandro.
Bye.
We're done.
Luchador appropriation. I was right. I thought it was that.
Yep.
So I guess it wasn't an insensitive question, but... Well, right in the asshole. Okay. So we got banned energy drinks and right in the asshole.
Gets out of dodge there.
Now, right in the asshole might really get some creeps.
From the Mexican luchador. Oh, no! Over the top.
Oh my God!
Onto the apron right in front of us. look at the urgency of Dragon Bane.
Yeah. Fast on it. You saw Ninja Mac face first.
Yeah, absolutely. Onto brutal. The apron. Absolutely brutal, G-Man. This could be his biggest win in the arc to date if he can put away Ninja Mac.
Dragon Bane!
So are you kidding me?
He's done it!
Wow, he's done it.
That was something else we just witnessed in this four-way battle match.
Here's Dragon Bane.
On the arc. A treat for the fans here in the Edion Arena, Osaka, Japan. A treat for the
That was great.
Universe
that was fun. Lots of spots.
That was something special.
Like Andrew Heelan said earlier in the chat, could have used some replays.
All you can could've say
used
about
a
that
few
match, folks,
replays.
Was wow.
But that's okay.
This story involves a wrestler who has one wish. He wants to go out a winner. But then again, what else would a loser wish for?
I'd been with Dirk for 20 years. Tonight he was retiring.
How do you feel, champ? You ready for that last big hurrah?
You know, Tony, I didn't get that far in this business, but at least I'm going out a winner. Thanks for doing that much for me.
Hey, it's the least I can do. Listen, how you doing, financially?
My brother's got word in to his boss at the engine plant. They're looking for part-timers.
Evening, gents.
What's this?
I just want to let you know about a little change in tonight's script.
Oh, my God, look at
Momar
that guy's hair.
Will be the winner, not Dirk.
Like hell he will.
Hey, wait a minute, fellas. This was set in stone. Dirk wins tonight. It's the last bout of his life, for God's sake.
You came in a loser. You're going out a loser. What's the big deal?
Now listen, Grant. This was a done deal.
I undid it.
Look at his hair. Oh, my God.
My guy had a grudge against Momar. He'd faced him 8 times before, and my guy lost every bout. Look, I'm sorry, champ. I don't want you to get hurt. So for tonight, I think we'll just stick to the script.
No. Nothing changes my mind tonight, Tony. Nothing.
Oh, he's going into business for himself, Daddy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And the
it's not. It's not our main event. This guy's a babyface. They love him. How is that guy a babyface?
And his worthy opponent, making his final World Wrestling Appearance.
'Sakes, Dirk, it's not worth it.
If you're not behind me on
they're
this,
they're booing
Tony,
the working
leave,
man and
myself.
Cheering this Pharaoh character.
Everyone knew that Momar was younger, stronger, and meaner than Dirk. They were both showmen who liked to excite the crowd. Dirk was trying to turn back the clock.
Dirk with a headlock.
Momar brought him back to reality.
Momar
fast
with a punch. Demolition Dirk on the outside now.
Dirk was acting the part of the loser right now. This was the part he played the
acting
best.
Acting the part of the
he
loser.
He didn't belong in the same ring with Momar.
Oh, I know that.
And Momar wanted
I've
to
been there,
the
brother.
Point.
That's the part
my
of the loser.
Was using all his acting techniques to make Momar's attack look worse than it was. And he was fooling the crowd, me and Momar at the same time.
Get out of here.
Momar gave him the airplane spin, but Dirk knew how to fall to absorb the punishment.
There's some guy at home saying he knows how to fall.
But this night, Momar didn't look like he wanted to dance. When I first met Dirk, he seemed to have eyes in the back of his head. That's my boy.
That's my boy.
These two guys were great performers who knew how to give the crowd what they wanted. I try to keep telling myself, there's no business like show business.
Hey!
It's called Beyond Belief.
Momar was sending Dirk a message.
Right.
Fact or fiction.
Loud and clear.
Leave me alone, loser! You're going out a loser!
Don't you listen to him, Dirk! You're a winner! Go out a winner!
You can beat this guy, you can do it! You can go out a winner!
We'll be checking back in with Dirk and the gang. Meanwhile, I don't remember what this is. Oh my! Mecha Mummy. This was sent in by Cool Dude Food, Owen Straw, the man who makes the original music on the show.
このね、若者をチェックしているファンの方だったわけですね。あのちょっと話題になった記者会見、はい、あれすごかったですね。そうですね。あの衝撃と書いてですね、笑う方なんですけどね。マスコミも選手もみんな笑ってました。全くいわゆる記者会見になってなかったですね。まあおそらく戦いというよりかその選出が違ってくるでしょう。誰がこのリング上で目立てるかと。
いった戦い、ある意味シビアな戦いがこれから臨場で繰り広げられると思います。まず入場してきたのは松山勘十郎と菊太郎。そして不気味な機械音がこの新宿フェイスに響いております。まあでもあの福田さん、はい、若武者でなぜマミーなんですかね。マミーもデビューしてるんですよね。There you go。メカマミー。2万なんですよね。And Mummy Light。プロレスデビューしてミネミマ。Check my notes。まああの
彼らはね、メカであるながらマミーですから、ミイラになってるぐらいですから、いわゆるその実年齢、まあ年齢と言っていいのか分かりませんが、多分何千年でしょうけどね。まあ一応レスラーキャリアですよね。なるほど。2年というくくりで考えるのであれば、もう若武者だろうと。そして今回マミーズは何かストロングスタイルを標榜して、象徴であるこのクロパンツを履いてるんですよね。素晴らしいですね。
あ、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今ちょっとスピーカーリサポーで。そうですね。あの、今
something.
He looks familiar to me. Perhaps he looks familiar to you as well.
はい、今からパソコンがお手元にありましたら立ち上げていただいて。
Mummy Light.
プロレスサミットの道のホームページで記者会見の動画が配信されていますので、それを見て、一刻も早く予習してみてください。
もうね、松山勘十郎ね、完全にいじられ
てき
た
ん
ですよ。そうなんです
よね。元々ですね、まあ、聞いたんですよ。なんでダフンダで反応するようになったのかと。
そう、あの、プッて口を膨らます
志村けんばりですよね。
してしまうんですよね。
はい。はい、あれはもうね、みちのくの控え室で、あの、いじられてて、ダフンダっていうと、ああやって顔を膨らますと。
いや、
ま
さに志村
けんですよね。
志村けんさんのリアクションですよね。はい、
それを見てて、みんながまた面白くいじり出したらですね、はい、あっという間にですね、インディーの枠の中でですね、はい、あのこうやってやれば面白いよっていう知れ渡ってしまったわけですね。
そして多分松山勘十郎選手もですね、最初はまあリアクションとして撮っていたんでしょうけど、そう何回も何回も言われたら多分なんか染み付いちゃったんでしょうね。
そうですね、控え室で行われてたこの 部分がですね、ついに表舞台に出てきたという
ですね、しまいましたね。お客さんにとって伝わりにくいかもしれませんが、
松山
打って勝って、やっぱメカマミーズはあれですね、
trips
言葉通りって言葉は発してませんが、ストロングスタンドですね、素晴らしいですね、
stand up、
まさに無限実行、
はい、まあでもね、冒頭のちょっと部分に戻りますけども、はい、そのキャリア2年というね枠で考えれば、
本当に一番若干難しい試合
でもあるんですよね。
なるほど。でも、
Here he is, Kikutaro. He don't stress me out.
大会を通じた時に、そのこういう要素は確実に必要なんですよ。あの過去インディーズと2回行ってないですけども、あのエンターテイメントマッチということで、男色 D のハンサムジョー、ハンサムジョーエンターテイメントという枠で捉えるのはどうかというキャラ、まあキャラクターの部分という形になるんですけれども、の試合があったんですけども、やっぱりそういう形でお客さんを少し和ます、楽しませる。やはりなんていうんですかね、あの試合ばかりだとですね、お客の見る方も疲れてしまいますからね。
ましてや菊太郎選手なんてね、まさにそういうポジションをね、
がっちりと作り上げましたから
ね、さあ、菊太郎とメカマミーの融合です。
はい、菊太郎 does nothing. メカマミー absorbs it, thrives, he loves it.
マッスルポーズで威嚇、しかしメカマミーもメカポーズで威嚇します。
負けんなほら、
Who is Mecha Mummy? And I hope he's doing well. Arm wrestling on the mat. Referees there to make sure.
Mecha
Mummy getting down.
The
oldest trick in the book. Kikutaro taking advantage of Mecha Mummy. Who's stupid?Nice elbow drop, tip of the hat.
さあ、しかし菊太郎の世界をマミーが拒否しました。間が持てなくなった菊太郎は思わず松山勘次郎にタッチです。さあ、ライトと松山です。まあ、メキシコから逆輸入されたジャパニーズ歌舞伎レスラー
というおしゃれですよね。
最初ね、この姿を見た時はどんなオリエンタルサッポーをやる選手なんだろう、最初のイメージとは全く180度違う方向に行ってしまいましたね、松山勘十郎選手。
マミーライト、イントゥザロープス、バッティングダブルティーム。
キャラクターありきでまず物事を進めていくのも今のプロレス界ではありだと思いますからね。
あ、どうやらこの歌舞伎ポーズに過剰反応しているメカマミーです。
Who would like my Instagram stories if it weren't for bots?
松井一郎の厳しいチェックミス。素直に従っています。
さすが若武者ですね。
よっしゃ。OK。感じる足出せ足。よしよしよし。
さあ、ダブルの攻撃。
出ましたね。
コーチプレーです。
お前、わざわざ足
りんな。ああ、うまいですね。
何も喋れない。
しょうがないですね。
ですね。もうあれは口をつぐんでですね、息を止めてしまいますからね。喋りようがないです。の
これはマセ
の感じのミサベ。絶
景から絶景から。
再度放置ですね。
Matsuyama is getting mad。
まあまた素直ですね。
素直ですね。全くみんながみんな好き勝手なことやってますね。あ、しかし見えていません松山勘十郎。ダブルのサーフボードストレッチ。
やっぱりこ
のストロングスタイルのパンツがある分ルールに厳格で、ああついに脱ぎ捨てた。
もう我慢できなくなりましたね。
Oh、God,
ついにストロングスタイルを放置しました。マミースタイルメカビストでボッコボコです。
松井
レフリーがもうリング上はおろか若武者のコンセプトすら守りきれなくなってきています。
メカライトダックス、
しかしライトはまだこの象徴であるストロングスタイルの黒パンツを履いている。
メカレカマミー、
そしてすでに見えてしまったメカマミー、躊躇なくメカフィスト。
Damn, that fist is big. It's knocking everybody out.
いいパンチの連打ですよ。
He's so happy.
怒った勘十郎と菊太郎、ダブルの攻撃を見せる。
クロー getting double teamed。
外してってダブルのクローズライン。
今ね、場外でライトもね、招待を脱ぎ捨てましたよ。
ついにライトも放棄、あ、本当だ、ライトもストロングスタイルをつけましたね。
あ、メカマメイガーノーツタンク。
ミイラだから腐りきってしまったのでしょうか。しかし生身の菊太郎にはもの、
あー、セーフィー、そうです、レフェリ
ー条件反射でね、中継でバット
レットで人を出して
しまうんですよね。
あー、危ない、あー、セーフリーの、あー、セーフリー、
That ref will never be the same。
あ、もうダメですね、
これはしばらくトイレがきついですね。
もうレフリー不能になりました。まあ、人間はね、口が要するに入るとこと出るとこは大切ですからね。その一つを完全に破壊されてしまいました、松井
ゆみ。さあ、
そう、
They're presents from God。
カロンのシャイニングキスード、
シャイニングウィザード、
しかしのリュットパンチ、
big fist to the face、
速攻部に痛烈にヒット、
見事にヒットしましたね。さすがですね。
いやー、もう
使
い
こなします
ね。遠隔操作されてますからね、メガですから。100発100中です。さあ、感じ
る
よう
になると
。もう一気にかわされました。ロープに振っていく。おっと、これをフェイントでかわして。まさに感じるらしいエルボードロ
ップ。お、見せ場が来ますよ、感じるの。
先ほどはね、菊太郎にジャックされました。
マツヤマ slipping。
やっちゃいましたね。
メカライト、カーン slipping。
ここからですね、ロープ渡りが一つの見せ場になるんですが。
すいませんでした。
ある意味神が降りてしまいましたね。
いける？若武者やから。やっていいか。
I do not know if this is DDT. I don't think so.
町長頼む。
町長。あ、町長か、町長か。
お前が長所だ
と。よく分かってないみたいですね。
そうでなくて、その下にあるんだよ。
ちゃんとね、用意してるんですよね、毎回。
ピキタル looking under the road or under the ring for something。
ハミテープでどっか行っちゃったかと思いました。
逆。
逆。まあ、これどうするんだ。
あ、そうそうそうそうそう。
こうか。
よしよし。
こうか。
どうし
よう。Oh my god。
What
is this? Is
あれ。
How dare you say wrestling is an art? Look at this! Oh, he's hit with the fist from Mecha Mummy.
Kanjuro! Kanjuro!
Chocho is still running.
まあ、あの Chocho は Kanjuro にとってお花畑の Chocho になってしまいました。かなり寄せが行っている。
やめて、やめて。
そしてライトのクレオパトラ。ダフンダが助けました。
この手がありましたね。
もう8割方カンジューロの邪魔しかしてなかったダフンダがついに救うことになりました。あっと、ここでメカマミーが背後からスリーパーホールド。最後の最後でストロングスタイルを持ってきた。
ダフンダ、
あ、いや、ダフンダ、今のダフンダダメですよ。これダフンダいっちゃダメですよ。
ダフンダ
息詰まっちゃいますからね。
ダフンダ、ダフンダ、
ダフンダ、落ちた、落ちた、落ちた。
looks like he's going to sleep。
ダフンダ、あれ、おお、感じろ、
あら、あら、あら、やばい、やばい。これでギバップになっちゃいますよ。
おお、耐えた、耐えた、耐えた。
よかった。
Matsuyama, no, he's not.
Kikutaro, 全く空気が読めていなく今、松井レフェリーがゴングを要請です。
Oh, wow.
You're winners. 10分25秒、スリーパーホールドからの TKO 勝ち。
The mummies, the mechas.
明らかに敗因は Kikutaro ですね。
ですね。
Well, thank you.
本当にね、分かってるのに
押しとしました。This one in.
いや、わざとですかね。
That's great, great finish.
しかし、
He fights back and immediately goes down.
体が反応してしまうがゆえの悲しい敗北となってしまいました。
おそらくですね、カウントをですね、返すのは起き上がるのはですね、ダフンダのは予測できたと思うんですよ。体がそう反応するだろうと。スリーパーにおいてはそこまでは菊太郎予測できなかったんでしょうね。
メカマミーズ very happy。
ダフンダというと筋肉がクッと硬直するからキックアウトできたんですけども、締め技の時に硬直してしまうとね。
そうなんですよ、
全くの逆効果
で、
途中で逆にダメだ、押し通して笑いを取ろう、その方向に行きましたね。
バカ菊太郎、ダフンダ、ダフンダってな、会見の時から貴様拙者一言も喋ってもらうんではないか。面白いのは分かるけどな、
順番はい。やる気ないなおい。これで自社ともに認知認知
された。Alright, I don't know what's going on there. Okay. Oh, hold on one second.Hold on one second. The whole world, the whole wrestling world is excited about MJF and Samoa Joe. Because they had a little fun thing in NXT when MJF was just a boy. He was playing like he's a security guard and Samoa Joe pushes him. We got a great gif of that we all enjoyed for years and years. And then they called it back.And now we're gonna have a Joe MJF feud. Very cool. I like it. Now here's what they should do next. Here's the next feud that should be born out of some WWE thing. This one. That's Ricky Starks.
Okay. How are you today?
You got a whole bunch of stuff up.
I'm doing great, man.
Yeah. Hungry.
Yeah.They've been pretty good so far.
What'd you just say to me?
Nothing, sir.
You look like you're about to say something to me.
I wasn't.
You got a problem?
No, sir.
Hey.
Ask your question. What'd you want to say to me?Just like you say to the big guy. You scared? You hungry? Huh? That's your question.
Yeah, I think it is. You hungry? Hey! He's got tuna salad in his ear now. Ryback.
Is that what you wanted? You see that table? That's the kind of table I'm gonna put John Cena through tonight.I could put you through this table right now. Is that what you want?
No, sir.
No.
Somebody
get some help.
Now we just need Ryback to show up on Collision. Now Ryback can show up on Collision now that Punk is gone. All right, that's that. Now, Freddie, who the hell is Freddie Valentine? Well, Dr. Liam, Crimson Mask Replica on Instagram, he let me know. Remember last week when we watched Terry Funk and Mom, Can I Keep Her? The bad movie about a Malcolm in the Middle kid who gets a gorilla that...ran away from Terry Funk's character, Jungle Ed, we all remembered. If not, go watch last week's episode, Flamin' Ape. It's on YouTube. It's a good one. Apparently, the director of that movie was once a wrestler. And here's his little highlight package as a wrestler.That's him. He directed children's things and almost porn things. Turn this bad, awful music down. Yeah, he looks like 911's little brother.311. I love how many of his highlights are just getting whooped. Wait, that's a real alligator. That's a shoot alligator. There's the Funker. Valentine, a friend, he's a friend of Terry Funk's apparently, and he directed at least one other movie with Terry Funk in it, and I'm starting to clip it now. I didn't have it ready for this episode. Perhaps we'll watch it. We are now in hour number two of the Pro Wrestling Potluck. Still to come, we're going to find out what happened with Demolition Dirk. We're going to see a main event that's going to be great. Some other stuff I forgot, but you know what I didn't forget? There ain't no Babylon 5 coming. There never will be.
Bottom wrist lock, lateral drop into a head scissors by Wrestling 2. Tenru trapped in that head scissors now.
All right, back to Dirk.
You're a winner. Go out a winner. You can beat this guy. You can do it. You can go out a winner.
Suddenly, all the years of sweaty locker rooms, cheap hotels, and broken marriages were showing on Dirk's face. Omar seemed to be standing for every failure in Dirk's life, and he was not going to get even.
Get his ass, Dirk! He's shooting! He's shooting!
I'm just getting started, too!
It's a shoot Irish whip.
The crowd was with him now.
This is a Demolition Dirk. He's playing Demolition Dirk. He's supposed to retire. He's supposed to win, but the plans change, and he don't want to really change with the plans.
For me, it was a lifetime. But at least my guy was going out like a champion. Omar's corner always thought he could come back against Dirk. But now they were starting to believe that man could lose.
This is the Dirk double turn.
Omar's shoulders were on the mat, ready to be counted out.
Winner, winner!
Spinning toehold. He got pinned by a spinning toehold, folks.
Against all odds, against a superior opponent, Dirk had finally beaten the man he could never beat. What a way to go out. Then I saw the doctor went over to examine Momar.
This man's dead. He's ice cold.
He's ice cold.
Been dead for at least 20 minutes.
Oh my God.
You're wrestling a dead man.
You got a fucking great match out of a corpse, Dirk.
I'll never forget the look on Dirk's face. Even in victory, he was a loser. Now he couldn't take away with him the satisfaction of beating his arch rival.
Beat him to death.
Of course, Dirk's real rival was never Momar in the first place. In the end, his real opponent turned out to be Lady Luck.
That guy's dead. He's been dead for 20 minutes!
So what really happened in the ring?
I don't know, Frank.
Was Dirk Simmons
really wrestling a dead man?
Yeah.
Could his own adrenaline have been pumping so hard that he didn't realize that he was getting no resistance from his opponent? It certainly didn't look that way to the crowd. Perhaps the doctor was mistaken about the time of death. Maybe Muammar really did die only moments before the doctor examined him. Then again,
they were wrestling for a while. They showed a little clock going around. He was running the light. Stopped beating.
Was this story fact or fiction?
Fact.
That's a problem we leave you to wrestle with.
We'll find out whether this story is true or false at the end of our show.
Oh my God, I don't have that part.
Prison break.
I don't have the part where we find out if it's true or false. I just have this one clip.
I got a letter and some video from a Chicago public school teacher named Chris Kowalski. And she says, I am the aunt of WWE professional wrestler CM Punk, a.k.a. Phil Brooks. In 1986, my family finally got the chance to go down to the Bozo show after waiting 10 years for tickets. I was 19 and my nephews,
I don't know if you guys have seen
Michael
this.
And Philip, were 10 and 8. Anyway, Phil was chosen to play the game at the end of the show. Not only did Phil win the game, this is CM Punk, Phil.
Yeah. CM Punk on the Bozo show, folks.
His trademark humor and cockiness. I think he was destined for the world of the WWE. Okay, this is what the wrestler CM Punk looks like now. And here he is on the old Bozo show back in 1986. CM Punk is the boy who is to the right of Joey DeOrean. Take a look.
When the music stops, it's eliminated. You got it? So you don't want to be wearing this when the music stops. Huh? That's good. I'll do the jokes, okay?
I can't understand what little Punk said.
When are you gonna start?
Bozo, I think your son is here. Anyway, go. Are you?
What am I looking?
I don't know.
Right of Joey, there's...
Now, Joey is Bozo, so I think he was the kid to the right of the other guy.
It's coming up here.
This is a fun game, though.
There he is, the kid that won right there. That's CM Punk.
Ladies wow. and gentlemen, the comedian is our winner right here.
Bozo rules, dude. I used to watch Bozo. I think Bozo is the shit. And Cookie...
Yeah, here, you hold on to that.
Okay. Well, they
were... he won a new and exciting game from Parker Brothers called Don't Wake the Dragon.
What do you think of that? Huh?
Here's an exciting match game of cards and dice
by the makers of Uno. You know what it's called?
No, what's it called?
Luck Plus. Oh. And it's for the other players. What do you think of that?
But wait, there's more. Everyone is going to get a look at this.
What is it?
It's a brand new shampoo. It's called Created. It's for kids. And it has a no-tears formula. And this one is bubblegum scented. One for everybody.
Wait a minute. Jay, give me Bozo video.
Every kid wants to win shampoo.
Oh, why? Did I eat it now?
No, you
wow,
can't.
I got shampoo. Happy birthday, George South. Here's a George South promo.
Like nobody here. You know that? It's right up over our redneck. I was here.
We'll spin the Terry Funk wheel after this. I forgot. I was going to do it earlier.
Because you are a lot uglier than that crowd was last year. Hey, how many kids you got? Dang, lady. How many kids you got? They need a whooping. Take a bath.
How many kids
have
you got?
How many kids have you got, lady? You're taking up that whole side over there. Listen. It is okay to whoop your kids. Please. You need a whooping,
too,
you ugly thing.
You need a whooping, too, you ugly thing.
You're the ugliest woman I ever seen in my life. Oh, you come here. That's too far to walk. You come here!
You're too late!
I ain't gotta ask you how many kids you got, you too ugly! Listen, I don't have to stand here and take this! Listen, you walk this far, you're gonna have a heart attack! Listen, it take about five people to pick her up!
You ain't got enough to make a damn you! Shut up! You're so damn ugly, you ain't old enough!
in the world.
Hold on a minute. I'm not the bad guy. All these people that have kids are.
That's true.
I'm gonna give you a chance.
I'm not the bad guy.
This ring, okay? I'm gonna give you a chance to leave, and he'll raise my hand, and we'll just call it even, okay?
I didn't click on the Beyond Belief. Is the wrestler thing true or false? Can someone spoil it? Fact or fiction? I gotta know. So this is the Wheel of Funk. And it's got Terry Funk matches from all times, all places, all eras. And we're gonna watch one right now. And let me know. Well, don't let me know. What are you gonna let me know? Everybody, put your positive vibes out, and let's see what we got.
They say we're out of control.
I love this song.
Juvenile delinquents, 'cause we like to rock and we like to roll.
We like to roll. That's when I spin the wheel from now on. Wheel of Funk, it's spinning. And I just realized I didn't take the thing out from last time. All Japan, no. Oh my God, Juggalos!
We're looking for some girls.
Yeah.
So we can party all night.
Piper versus Funk with a bunch of run-ins. And this is Roddy Piper's last match ever. And we'll watch that as soon as I dig it up.
After finishing the NDA this week, it's been good bipartisan cooperation and a string of...
And starting this moment from now, from this moment on, this will be the moment starting now of the genesis of McGillicuddy.
Can we hear from the winner now, please?
Hit the buzzer.
Let's hear it one more time from Michael McGillicuddy.
This is gonna get me. I'm scared of that. So we're gonna Frito twist it. I don't want the Eagles coming for me. Yeah, the Eagles. I don't want that. It's been a while.
My name is Bill. Here
nope.
To say you're not swinging until
Terry Funk.
You twist your troubles away. You do it like this.
The Frito beating twist. The ring announcer's ass. Let's see. The Juggalo said it looks like a prom. The Juggalo prom. That ref looks like a drug dealer.
From
This might be a fan cam. I don't know. I might be supplying the commentary. Roddy Piper with Cowboy Bob Orton.
I'm going to tell you something, Piper. You better keep your ass on the outside of the ring. And I might just run your ass out there.
He's swinging on the ramp.
I want to tell you something, Piper. My daddy, you know, I was an actor. I was an actor. Is this guy an actor? Hell no. He's not an actor. He's a worse actor. What's wrong with you, Piper?
Drug bridge greetings.
A little bit of a respect. You know, you're an idiot. My daddy. My daddy. He always told me if you bring an idiot horse to an idiot horse, do you know what you get?
What? This is the main event of the Juggalo Prom.
You're funked. Your brother was funked. Your father was funked. And I funked your mother.
Whoa. Hey.
You think you're a tough guy? You think you're...
I funked your mother.
I don't care if we're going to the house ball.
Referee! All right, referee, we have established that the referee has no control. Piper with the strap. Among the unwashed. Hey, they're back in the ring now. I feel like these edits are good. I'm glad to have edits. Piper into the ropes. Caught by Funk. Oh, now. A little too much editing now. Now all of a sudden they're both in the ring with Funk, who's bleeding now. Who's gonna run in? That's Twisted! That's Psychopathic Records recording artist Haystack! Hey, that's Cactus Freaking Jack! I'm gonna guess this is whenever Foley was in TNA. I think he wore that shirt a lot in TNA. Funk and Piper going at it in the corner. Captain Sack! I hope from Roddy. Hyper kicking him. Orton taking his time. That's what I thought too. That's Cactus Sack and Drunk Terry Flunk. That's how I know these people. I only know wrestling through the Stranglemania VHS tape. Mushroom Boys. Two! A kick out. Why? Three! And that is Piper's last match. I'll let the fans say it. Dr. Liam sent this, but also begged me not to play it. Begged me not to put it on the wheel. Wow, that's a career. I don't think that was Piper's retirement match. I think he just died after this, right?
When I try to get in, there's a reason why I'm retired. But I want to tell you guys something. With the exception of a few people who threw some stuff, I was a little worried about coming here. When you guys watch this show, you're going to see there are some moments just of genuine that we just love doing this stuff. Love seeing the guys out here.
No, he wore the that leopard print shirt in TNA.
And if you'll have me, I'll come back next year to the Gathering of the Juggalos.
Yeah. It must pay well. They pay well and they treat the boys well, right?
I damn sure don't want to wrestle you, Mick. No more.
A set of comedy at 4 a.m. Well, I'm laughing. Wow. What the hell? That's not all. Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right. That's right. All right. You got Dusty Rhodes coming out, polka dots, and his opponent who just left the ring in a hurry, George South. Happy birthday, George South. Hey, we had a WWE promo and a straight-up Monday Night Raw match. What the hell is going on? The forbidden toilet has been opened. George South. There you go. South getting going to work. Oh, work is over. Great bump, George South. I believe the Suzanimal sent this one in.
Although there's also only one like the big boss man.
Dusty Rhodes, listen to the sound, boy.
Boo!
The sound of pain clapping down around your wrist. Any man can steal from another man, getting away with it for keeps.
Big boss man turned off his big body camera.
You're gonna feel the pain of a lifetime, and you may not survive.
Boo!
Dusty Rhodes captaining his team, of course, the Dream Team, he calls it.
Well, you know, McMahon, I don't have no sympathy for Dusty Rhodes at all.
Right.
Because he did steal from the big boss man.
I don't recall Dusty Rhodes asking you or anyone else for any sympathy.
And, you know, thieves should be dealt with.
Oh my, Mr. Lucy Goosey.
Mr. Lucy Goosey. Mr. Lucy Goosey. That's what they call me. Now that I've thrown out the format of this show, you cannot predict this show.
The Dream is the captain of the Dream Team. Dusty Rhodes joining forces with Brutus Beefcake, Tito Santana, and the Red Rooster. Well, of course, their opposition being the...
the Big Lost Man.
Big Boss Man.
Wow.
Rick Martel and the Honky Tonk Man. Well, one thing about the Dream Team, they won't be lacking for color, will they? With Rhodes, Beefcake, and the Rooster. Yep.
Suplex on George South.
Why should we feel at home? We can cucaracha.
Oh man, Big Hoss Man. But then you need a an independent wrestler that's over 6 feet tall. That's very hard to find. I've seen some referees that are over 6 feet. Ooh, the elbow. George South down. The Dream. Elbow, that's it. There you go. There you go. Oh yeah, we don't have a lot of show left. We got the main event. We got a few fun videos in the main event. Nice elbow. George South, thanks for coming. Happy birthday. Dusty Rhodes, R.I.P.
Sure, yeah, we'll go up against Fozzie Bear and Kermit the Frog.
Ooh, they're tough.
Yeah, I
hey,
know.
I'm more Bozo.
You know what? We've got a little something for you.
Well, great. It's been a long day here in Chicago.
Here it is.
I love presents.
Thanks, Cook. Well, thanks, Bozo.
Okay. We'll see you next week on NWA Pro Wrestling. I love this job.
Let me warm up a little more. Maybe this will bring back a few memories. I'll catch it about midway through. Anybody who's anybody knows who Jimmy Buffett is. Goes a little like this. I blew out my flip-flop. Left on a pop top. Cut my heel, had to cruise on back home. But there's booze in the blender, and soon it will render.
This is why the show
that
started late.
That rose concoction, it helps me hang on. Wasted away again, a margarita bill. Searching for my lost shaker of salt. Some people claim that there's a rocky to blame. But I know it's old Stone Cold's fault. Oh, By the way, The Rock will never, ever forget.
The link! Up left! The Rock is thrilled off to the Rock Father! This is surreal!
I want to remind all of you kiddos out there to go ahead and not wind up in jail. Don't commit any felonies. Don't eat your vitamins. Go ahead and wear your drawers for 30 days, and you might be able to wind up and grow up to be like me. Now, all I want to say is, hoochie-coochie, awayness noches, and a so long to just about everybody but you, Crispy. We'll be back here next week on World.
Now, I should have played this last. My mistake. Got this from WCW Deep Cuts.
Chris, Ring of Honor / New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Now here we go. I got Suzannimal sent me the Rock and Stone Cold singing Margaritaville, and I goosed it up a little bit. And this he sent me some cheeseburger clips because he said that's all the Jimmy Buffett songs he knows. So here's a little cheeseburger doing some dad jokes.
It's all good. I'm bringing it back. My best
main event is right after this, folks.
I'm gonna succeed, actually.
I don't think it'll work.
I'm already doing it. Why did the coffee go to the police station?
Why?
Because it got mugged.
Nah.
No?
Nah.
Did you hear that Steve Harvey and his wife got into a fight?
No. What happened?
It was a family feud.
That's not good.
All right. This...
One of these will get me.
What do you call a person that doesn't fart in public?
What?
A private tutor.
Nah.
No?
Nah.
That's pretty good.
Have a good one.
Thank you, too.
What's brown and sticky?
Brown and sticky. I mean, a lot of things.
A stick.
Nah.
No?
Nah. Y'all almost, but
I think that got me.
Why didn't the vampire
it want sucks. To
play Taylor Swift?
Why?
Because she had bad blood.
I don't get it. Is that a Taylor Swift song?
The chairman's laughing at the joke, or are you laughing at my joke?
I think he's laughing at me laughing at you. Me laughing at you.
What do you call a fake noodle?
What?
An impasta.
That's pretty good.
Alright, that was good. The family was the best one.
Thanks, Steve Harvey.
No, it wasn't. Folks, this is your main event. Happened, I should know how many years ago, but it happened a long time ago. I want to say 95, maybe earlier. And it's from the Necro Eric Vault. I'm accepting submissions for this show. And one day, Necro Eric sent me 1,490 submissions. We call it the Necro Eric Vault. Panama! Alright, I'll be right back. Yoko Inoue coming out to Panama, and now the great Bull Nakano has entered the ring. Oh, this is from 1991. I said 95, I couldn't have been more incorrect. Kyoko Inoue, who we saw in last week's Buzzbin match, is in this week's Tonight in History. Grateful Dead shirt. Now, what do you think? You think Bull Nakano is wearing that shirt because it looks cool, has a big skull, and is tie-dyed? Or do you think she listens to Jerry and the boys mess around on guitars for 5 hours? For my money, Bull Nakano in a Megadeth shirt is as cool as it gets. Kyoko into the ropes, hits a brick wall known as Bull Nakano. Second time. Ooh, each time she's breaking through a little more. Grabs the legs. Boston Crab very early in the match. Trying to wear down Bull. Forearms. Getting Bull into the corner. Irish whip reversal. Oh, God. I thought right in the face. This is our main event tonight, folks. Hey, watch the hair. Ramming her head and her hair into the ring post. This is Kyoko Inoue before she discovered fringe. She gets more and more fringe as the years go by. Oh. Look at the strength. Bull's bleeding. Wow. The ring post, I guess?
あとね、井上京子の場合、テクニシャンっていうか技の方がね、その方が、すごく目を奪われがちなんだけど、この人は実際にはすごくパワーがあるんですよ。結構ね、ブルに対してもパワーでね、対抗できると思うんだよね。本人もそれを。Kyoko
Inoue in control in the first few minutes of this match. Bull Nakano is down and bloodied and in a submission. The tide may be turning. Lariat. Lariat though. Two dos. Powerbomb on Kyoko. Oh my god, a falling powerbomb. Two! Kyoko Inoue was looking great. And now Bull Nakano is pissed. Waistlock on Bull Nakano.
He's
looking to get out of it. Putting her ankle behind the foot of Kyoko Inoue.
をやっていくうちに、はい、見えだんだんだんだん見えてきて、
今アイリッシュウィップ、はい、ducks、おお、the abdominal stretch、
ブルがこういう技をやられ
てるんです
ね。そうですね。跳ね返しますね、普段は。はい、やっぱりね、ラリアードあるんですよ、これ農業も。さあ、ラリアード小腹ツイストで返して、それをフルホールアウタックルです。そして、飛びつけヘッドスタース。さすが、テクニシャンブリの内内強化監督。ああいうのがポンポン出てくるとすごいことですね。 はい、やっぱり自分のペースに持ってこれということですね。
ただあれをホールにするまでにはそれなりのダメージがないとね、
はい、それは難しいね。意味のない技ですか？
意味のない技にならないようにそれなりのダメージを持ってこないと。
はい、Wow, look at Bo, my God!
技と技のつなぎっていうのは、あの必殺技でもやっぱり単なる痛み技になってしまうという
Jesus!
怖さがありますよね。
そうですね。なんかこの井上京子だったらなんか
Her face looks like one of those metal bands where the I can't read the font, I can't tell what it says. That's what her face looks like, but red.
ダブルデスロックです。そして
え？
これは簡単なんですけども膝を
当てることで従来の簡単とは
違う膝つきのカンパーナです。
これも井上のオリジナルですね。
はい、
こんな技もブリやられたことないんじゃないかな。
ないでしょうね。
今日はブリどうしちゃったんでしょうね、うん、
そういう面ではいろんな面でダメージ大きいかもしれないね、
はい、
She's saying, no, I ain't tapping out, I ain't giving up. Give up?
ラフから来て、はい、これだけの技が仕掛けるということはやはり井上の成長、これは認めなくちゃいけないですかね。
そうですね。
I'm thinking, what are the odds that somebody does another move that's right in the asshole? That will cement that as the title of this episode, right in the asshole. Because of the two spots that happened earlier in the show. There's got to be one more right in the asshole. Uh-oh, surfboard coming. He's got the legs hooked. Rocking. Book rocks out of it, I think. But Kyoko's holding on. Annoyed, trying again. Got the legs hooked. Said, let's go. Once again, Bull is not being cooperative. Putting a stop to these surfboard attempts.
Ooh.
Third time. Sharpshooter coming. Scorpion. No. We've seen this. Oh my God.
ここまでの展開で全くこういう展開を予想した人は少ないと思うんですけども。
When I was looking at shows and matches that happened on this day to see if there's anything I possibly want to put on the show, and this came up, I was like, okay, well, this is going on the show. It's probably the main event. And I thought, did we already watch this? We didn't, because I would have remembered Bull Nakano's bloody face from 20 seconds ago. I would have remembered it forever. Kyoko Inoue looking for a suplex. Roll up by Bull Nakano. After all those submission moves, Bull is not as worn down as you'd think. Ooh. Rebound elbow. Two. Dos.
Blue, how is Inoue's
Oh, tries again. Bull got her. Kyoko Noi's face paint's almost gone. Ooh, foot on the ropes. Oh. The skewer spot made me scream. Because I don't watch a lot of deathmatch wrestling. I watch when the people that I know dip their toe into deathmatch wrestling, and then I'm like the perfect little mark, and I scream at everything. Ooh. Noi gets out of it. Crafty. But Bull, like a bear, right back. Referee, do you have to slap her face so much? Is that something referees do? Have I missed this? Are referees just slapping people, or is he just taking liberties, going into business for himself?
はい。リバウンドっていうのはだんだん時間が経つと、記憶が薄れてくるっていう、そういうことでいいんですか?意識がなくなってくるということですね。拷問技としてプロレスのホールドの中でも、プロレス誕生してすぐ誕生したこのスリーパーホールドです。バックから密着して相手を 二の腕で締め上げるって最も原始的しかし豪快な技です。二の腕はこれキックで返してエルボーです。
I've seen you post some deathmatch stuff, Nathan, on Instagram. Follow Nathan on Instagram, Cheap Heat Spot Fest. Cheap Heat Spot Fest on Instagram posts a lot of good stuff. Whoa! On the ropes, rebounds with a drop kick. Bull is down.
Two.
Pardon me. Whoa! Attempt at a swing. He's on a kick of mixing deathmatch with pop music. Now, if that's not the best advertisement for Cheap Heat Spot Fest on Instagram, I don't know what is. Give him a follow. Oh my god. Nice bridge from Bull on that backdrop suplex. The double choke. There you go. Bull with my favorite submission in all of wrestling. The Dragon Sleeper. Kyoko. Ooh, up and over, waist lock. Bull holds on. I know he's trying to rip her away from the ropes. The referee shaking his head. Two! Uh-oh, on the shoulders of Bull. Oh, back on her feet. She ducks away. Waist lock. German with the bridge. Two. And Bull's foot touched the ropes as well. Kyoko Inoue could do this. Wow, the strength. Kyoko Inoue is still loopy. I just want to imagine Bull Nakano as a professional golfer looking, I know she doesn't, but I just imagine her looking exactly the same. On the ropes. Oh my god! Did that connect? The Joshi Bridge! Whoa! Cartwheel from Bull. Double underhook suplex with a bridge. Dos. That's what I wish I retired when I was 25. Oh, power bomb. Kyoko Inoue is down. And Bull Nakano is sending to the top. Leg drop, one of the best leg drops in the biz. Referee is astonished. Crowd is hot. Superplex, perhaps? No. Oh, wow! Drop kick on the top rope. Bull goes to the outside. On her feet still. Kyoko Inoue. Acai. No! Wow! Just throwing her body. I thought it was Acai Moonsault. Bull taking a little sip. Sip of seltzer. Kyoko maybe looking for a power bomb of her own. Oh my god. Oh, sit out. Two. Bull landed right on her head, or at least right on her hair.
ちょっと落差がなかったですね。いや。そして、井上京子2段目から波を見舞うのか。さあ、リング中央のブルーをミスだ。ミサえてる。ダイビングのリプレイス。カウント2。
Leg drop of her own.
これやっぱり慣れないから犬京子お尻が痛いみたいですね。今ビデオ打ちましたさ。慣れない技。はい。自分のビデオ打ってしまいました。ああ、クリアスワンダがやはり通じないのか犬京子。ああ、これ。すごい。
Oh. Oh, that looked nasty. Inverted DDT, but lifted her up before. Implant inverted DDT, that's what I'm calling it. Ball from the top. Moonsault! Your winner after a freaking moonsault. Bull Nakano. That was awesome. Your winner. All right, that was your main event. Happened in 1991 on this date. Thanks for watching, everybody. That's your potluck. That's our potluck. It's ours. It's our potluck. Thanks for tuning in. This was a fun one. This was one where right at the last minute I was making changes and being like, well, it looks like I didn't finish this, so let me put this in instead and this and that. So I'm sure it came out like that, but this was a fun one. Let's see if that Gunther-Chad Gable match makes it to YouTube. I seriously doubt it, but you never know. And it doesn't matter, because I was like, oh, but I wanted to watch it, and I'm glad other people wanted to watch it. And hey, we gave a little company called WWE a chance on this show. And a couple things to plug. I'm doing commentary for Legacy Pro Wrestling. Every week, they're putting out two matches from the show a month or two ago, where I also did ring announcing, so it's a double dose of me. And check it out, The Future of Pro Wrestling, Trained by the Amazing Red, the House of Glory student shows, Legacy Pro Wrestling. Check it out on YouTube. Yeah, so there you go. This was a fun one. Next week, I know I said this for the past 2 weeks, but I'm trying to do this outdoor version of the show. It's going to be great. That's the next gimmick episode coming. But I need a couple things because I'm going to do it on the balcony right over there. So check that out. Anything else? I don't think so. So that's it. Thank you, everybody. Give me a follow on Instagram if you can. Give me a follow here. Subscribe if you like. I get a half of that money, and I need it. I appreciate it. So there you go. Thanks, guys. This will be on YouTube soon. If I have to edit out a match, it won't be that soon, but you know, we'll see. Good night, everybody. Thank you for being so beautiful. We did it.